Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. God, who sent the bishop, St. Paulinus of York, to build up your church, grant, we beseech you, by his prayers and example, that we may make known your wonders and tell of your truth, that with him we may receive the reward you prepare for all your faithful. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, for ever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. The law says, if you remember that Abraham had two sons, one by the slave girl and one by his freeborn wife, the child of the slave girl was born in the ordinary way. The child of the free woman was born as the result of a promise. This can be regarded as an allegory. The women stand for the two covenants. The first, who comes from Mount Sinai, and whose children are slaves, is Hagar. The Jerusalem above, however, is free and is our mother, since Scripture says, shout for joy, you barren women who bore no children. Break into shouts of joy and gladness, you who were never in labor. For there are more sons of the forsaken one than sons of the wedded wife. So, my brothers, we are the children, not of the slave girl, but of the freeborn wife. When Christ freed us, he meant us to remain free. Stand firm, therefore, and do not submit again to the yoke of slavery. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May the name of the Lord be blessed forever.
May the name of the Lord be blessed forever.
Praise, O servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. May the name of the Lord be blessed, both now and forever. May the name of the Lord be blessed forevermore. From the rising of the sun to its setting, praise be the name of the Lord. High above all nations is the Lord, above the heavens his glory. May the name of the Lord be blessed forevermore. Who is like the Lord our God, who stoops from the heights to look down upon heaven and earth? From the dust he lifts up the lowly, from the dung heap he raises the poor. May the name of the Lord be blessed forevermore. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Because of your love, give me life, and I will do your will.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The crowds got even bigger, and Jesus addressed them. This is a wicked generation. It is asking for a sign, The only sign it will be given is the sign of Jonah. For just as Jonah became a sign to the Ninevites, so will the Son of Man be to this generation. On Judgment Day, the Queen of the South will rise up with the men of this generation and condemn them, because she came from the ends of the earth to hear the wisdom of Solomon. And there is something greater than Solomon here. On Judgment Day, the men of Nineveh will stand up with this generation and condemn it, because when Jonah preached, they repented. And there is something greater than Jonah here. The Gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Be seated for a moment. Of course, most importantly about the Gospel, our Lord's reference to Jonah is a reference to his coming 3 days. Jonah spent 3 days in the whale, and our Lord will spend 3 days in the earth before his resurrection. I think it's fair to say that St. Paul talks an awful lot about two things in particular: law and freedom. You could say it's a sort of mega theme, really, freedom in Christ. So it's a good opportunity today just to sort of pause, really. And there's an interesting detail in what he says. He says that the Jerusalem from above, he refers to the Jerusalem from above being the source of our freedom in Christ. A wonderful expression, really, which touches on the fact that we somehow participate in heaven whilst we're on earth. Very profound teaching, but it is actually the truth, the centre of our faith. St. Paul talks about the law as having served the purpose of pointing out what's wrong, but that without the grace that comes from God, if we're just trying to do good just on our own strength, without God's power, that is grace, then we fall into trouble. And in fact, we're in a hopeless situation, according to Paul. So it's really an opportunity also to remind ourselves of the importance of the life of grace. Our Lord talks in different ways, using different metaphors about the life of grace. He talks to the Samaritan woman at the well about water welling up inside to eternal life. He talks about us being joined to him, the true vine. We are the branches and he is the vine. The sap that flows into our very souls is his grace. So it's very important to remember, and we can all very easily fall into it, a sort of thinking we have to do it on our own strength. Sometimes we're raised to think we have to be independent, and we forget that everything we do has to come from God. There's a wonderful collect in one of the Mass propers that says something like, God, you prompt all our actions and we ask you to complete them with your all-powerful grace. So what St. Paul's talking about is the fact that grace is given to us. We're given this amazing freedom in Christ, but it's not a freedom to just go and do what we want in a selfish sense. It's not a freedom just to be free from something. It's a freedom for something. It's a freedom at its deepest level for love. It's a freedom to be able to choose to love in Christ. And that's something incredibly profound and deep, and that sometimes has to bear with great suffering as well. It's that kind of love that enables the martyrs to go all the way in their faith. It enables St. Mother Teresa to feed and care for those who are the most destitute in society. And it's that kind of love that in our own way we're called to share in our everyday lives. The example of St. Paulinus is set before us today as we take up our daily tasks and occupations. Let us pray with heart, therefore, and firm in trust.
For all pastors, especially for bishops everywhere, that they may tend the flock entrusted to them with care, courage, and perseverance. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
For all who work in parishes, pastors, assistants, and co-workers, that they may be agents of the Holy Spirit who leads the people of God into unity. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
For priests and religious who engage in the work of Christ in difficult and trying situations, that their courage may not fail them in their hours of trial. May Christ, the good pastor, be their inspiration and joy. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
For vocations to the priesthood, may the Lord call into his harvest young people who will speak to the people of our time with insight and conviction. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
For harmony among all who work for Christ, may petty factions not enter into their work for the kingdom of his love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
For those who have borne the burdens and toils of the years and who are now retired from active ministry, may God's peace dwell with them always. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us. We also pray for a new bishop for our diocese. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord our God, may the lives of your holy ones inspire us to greater endeavor in the service of your people. May our lives be abundant in good works through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Thank you. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice from your hands, for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept this sacrifice from your people, we pray, O Lord, and make what is offered for your glory in honour of blessed Saint Paulinus a means to our eternal salvation, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for as on the festival of Saint Paulinus you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Supper was ended. He took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of our God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Paulinus and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Amen.
Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received, O Lord our God, stir up in us that fire of charity with which blessed St. Paulinus burned ardently as he gave himself unceasingly to your church, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee we cry, for banished children of Eve. To you we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears.
Turn then, most gracious Advocate, your eyes of mercy towards us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of our womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God.
Make us worthy of the promises of Christ.
Almighty, everlasting God, who by the cooperation of the Holy Spirit didst prepare the body and soul of the glorious Virgin Mother Mary to become a dwelling place fit for thy Son, grant that as we rejoice in her commemoration, so by her gracious intercession, we may be delivered from present evils and from everlasting death, through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen.
St. Paulinus,
pray for us.
All holy men and women.